The Autodromo Enzo Edino Ferrari just returned to Formula One, and we got a race. G'day one and all, I'm Southpaw Racer. The last time Formula One raced here was 2006, and it's changed a bit since then, but obviously the track's been through a lot more changes than that throughout its history. And that's part of the reason why I'm into racetracks like I am. I love exploring how these venues evolved, what made them the way they are. Imola's evolution is tied to the history of motorsport, and safety in particular, and I reckon by learning about how this track's changed, you can gain a deeper perspective of how racing used to be, and why racetracks are designed the way they are now. I got curious though. Sim racing offers some great opportunities for different experiences. I'm hyped to see Grand Prix racing return to Imola's current layout, but can we gain an appreciation for its modern safety standards and facilities by taking the fish out of its water, so to speak? I jumped on my PC, took a virtual approximation of a generic F1 type car from a couple of years ago, and drove it around reconstructions of Imola's past layouts to see how it handled them. To sum it up, new car, old track, been there, done that. Well, maybe, but I'm going there and doing that again. Like my last video, I'm using Razer Studios Automobilista with the Formula Ultimate 2018. Four eras of Imola are available for the sim, and for my money, these are some of the most visually and physically accurate historic recreations available for a PC simulator. Why didn't I use Automobilista 2? Because I don't have Automobilista 2. That's the reason. Time to go back, Marty, to 1972. This is dated to just before the first chicane was added to the track, Variante Bassa, before the start-finish line, so this was as close to Imola's original layout as you can get. The track actually began as public roads. It wasn't until the mid-1970s that it was properly closed off, so this is a real old-school circuit with barely any safety features to speak of. You'd be crazy to drive a modern F1 car around here. Anyway, here's me driving a modern F1 car around here. Hello, me in the bottom left.
Oh, g'day, mate.
So, the run into Rivazza then, it's much quicker than it is now. Fourth gear at the first apex, short shifting into fifth, trying to just keep the rear end in check. I didn't quite succeed, but you got to get a fast exit onto this really long start-finish stretch. There's no chicanes at all on this layout, and the first turn, Tamburello, is basically an extension of the straight. I'm not using DRS, it's not enabled on this layout. And you can see I'm barely moving the wheel at all through Tamburello, and doesn't quite show how dangerous that corner was. The braking zone for Tosa is much later than I expected. Got a brake at the access road into fourth gear. I compromised the exit. There's no curb there to save you on the outside. Then it's the run up to Pirotella. Again, there's no curbs or runoff here, and it's lower downforce, so I got to tiptoe through there as best I can, and then down into Acquaminerale. It's so fast, breaking down into fourth gear, just easing back on, just touching the grass, and then I get another moment to rest, but it goes in the blink of an eye. You got to try and keep it to the left through here, which is a bit difficult to do when you're sitting so low in the cockpit, but then down into Rivazza again. Unfortunately, I overshot it slightly, missed both apexes, but I think I carried enough speed through there to get a nice exit onto the start-finish straight. That's a lap of Imola in 1972, and I completed it in just under a minute and 8 seconds.
Nice. Nice.
Fast forward to 1988, there are curbs everywhere now, and typical for the era, they're big. Don't have to worry about deleting lap times here, the track does it for you, and we've got a few chicanes now to slow cars down. Variante Bassa, as I said, in late 1972, then Variante Alta in 1974, and the chicane at Acquaminerale in 1981. How does a modern car do around here? Let's find out. You start with Variante Bassa, you gotta nail the exit out of here in third, possibly fourth gear, run over the curb on the exit, and it's a shorter run up to Tamburello than it was before, but it's still a completely flat out corner. I did stay offline slightly through there, but once again you get a real idea of how dangerous it was in that original era. Down into Tosa once again, the braking point is a lot later than I expected. I'm down into fourth gear again, just trying to keep the rear end in check over the exit curb. and then Pirotella. Fortunately, there's a curb there to save you, and you can carry a bit more speed through here because you have to wind up the downforce for all of these chicanes, like this one at Acqua Minerale, third gear, avoiding the curbs, just trying to keep up the throttle, get up into fourth and keep it turning for a nice exit up to Variante Alta. And just after the 100 marker, I'm basically pussyfooting it through here. I wanted to avoid those curbs as much as possible. I'm sure I could take a lot more speed through there. They certainly did back in the day. Then down to Rivazza. The first apex has been tightened up something chronic. It's almost a hairpin. And the exit, once again, incredibly fast. Short shift into fifth on the exit. And then the first part of Variante Bassa, sixth gear. Oh, it's so quick. I made so many mistakes there on my practice runs. And then a slightly compromised exit out of the final corner. That is a lap of Imola in 1988.
Whew. Righto. Couple of mistakes on that one, but it still felt pretty good.
Time to say goodbye to this layout though, because after the tragedies of 1994, the track was majorly reconfigured. Tosa, Pirotella, and Variante Alta were the only turns left untouched, and we now have two chicanes to open the lap at Tamburello and Villeneuve. The curbs are flatter now too, another sign of F1 track design evolving from the 80s and 90s. Here we go then. Variante Bassa to start things off. You got to nail the exit from there once again. It's in a slightly different spot to what it was on the 88 layout, but there's the start of the lap, and you got to prepare for Tamburello right away, braking into fifth gear. I'm just keeping the car stable over the curbs. It doesn't like those quick direction changes, especially down at Villeneuve, the next corner coming up. Watch this. Such a fast entry. And the corner is done before I know it. I probably took a bit too much curb there, as I would down at Tosa. Look at that. Car got majorly unsettled on the line. So up to Pirotella. Probably cost me a couple of tenths, but I can gain some of that back through here. Nice flat curbs, increasing my confidence through there. And have a look at Acqua Minerale. No chicane here anymore. Seventh gear entry down into fourth, and it's over before I know it. Then up to Variante Alta. It has been made faster still thanks to the flatter curbs. I could be a little bit more greedy through there, but once again, I probably took a bit too much. And then down into Rivazza. These two corners have been squared off on this new layout of Imola. Third gear for the first one and then up into fourth, just trying to balance it through there. It's a little bit slower than it used to be, but I enjoy the challenge. Flat out through the first part for Variante Bassa and then down into fourth gear just to keep the wheel spin under control. And that is the lap done. Finally, time for the current layout. Variante Alta was reconfigured in 2006, made slower, and the entire pit straight was revamped in 2008. For cars, it's now a flat-out blast all the way from Rivazza to Tamburello once again. The curbs, meanwhile, are flatter still, but we've got anti-cutting humps just beyond most of them, so you still have to be careful you don't take too much. Alrighty, Rivazza 2 is the acceleration point for starting the lap on this layout once again, so got to be very careful not to spin the wheels out of there. Kind of depressed that I don't have DRS in the sim, because I would have been able to reach a fair rate of knots down here. Down into Tamburello, it's fifth gear once again for stability, trying my best to keep it stable over the curbs, but I couldn't quite do it. Little bit of a slide, and that's a couple of tenths probably gone. Down into Villeneuve again, it's a very aggressive entry. I used quite a bit of the curb on the entry, but didn't quite maximize the exit. Into Tosa, bit of a cleaner line than with the 88 and 2001 layouts, but still think I could have maximized it a bit more. Pirotella then. Love this corner. Love how fast it is. Oh, that might have been lap time deleted this weekend. Down into Acqua Minerale. Seventh gear, sixth, fifth, fourth. It's there and gone. Use all of the curbs on the exit. I really love going through there. Then Variante Alta. It's a bit more awkward now. Right and then hard left. Bit slower through there now, but got to maximize the exit all the same. And then down to the final two corners down at Rivazza. Once again, third gear in the first one, short shifting into fourth, trying to maintain as much speed as possible. Don't go into the gravel trap on the exit. And that is the end of it. Across the line in eighth gear to start another lap. And there we go. Imola through the ages in a modern F1 car. My lap time was in the 1 minute 16s, so am I fast? No. Did I demonstrate how this track has changed over the decades? I hope so. Taking a modern F1 car around historic layouts might seem pointless, if not for just a bit of fun, but I reckon it highlights just how different motorsport is now. If you made it this far, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video, whenever that may be. Until then, like, comment, subscribe if you want, and hopefully Imola's return isn't a one-off. Maybe after 2022, if the racing gets better. See ya!